Hello, I'm Dave Slopsma from Dimensional Consulting, and today I'm going to talk about pattern datums. Pattern datums are a pet peeve of mine, or rather the lack of appropriate use of pattern datums is a pet peeve of mine. Let's see what I'm talking about. Say we have a plate here. The plate has four clearance holes and then another hole in the middle that's going to be located relative to these four clearance holes. These four clearance holes are going to maybe fit over some studs in an adjoining part, or they're going to be lined up with some threaded holes in an adjoining part. Bolts are going to go through, and all we care about is assembly. If we cared about location, if location were critical, then we wouldn't use four clearance holes. We would use a couple of dowel holes, or maybe a net hole and a slot, something like that. And we would call them out regardless of feature size. But if we just care about assembly, we just want bolts to go through the holes, and clearance holes to line up so that bolts will go through the holes, then location is not critical, and we will call these holes out max material condition and max material boundary, because that's what we do when we just care about assembly. So how would you dimension this part? All too often it's dimensioned like this. Of course, the flat surface is considered to be datum feature A, and that's appropriate. But then the designer will often choose one of these holes and designate it datum feature B, choose another hole, designate it datum feature C, and locate these two holes relative to A and B and C. That implies that these two holes are more important than these, that they somehow play a bigger role in locating the part than these do. But in reality, out in the plant, somebody's going to pick up this part out of a bin, he's going to slap it on whatever other part is there, maybe slide it over some studs, or just line it up with some threaded holes, put his bolts through, and he has no idea which two holes were called out as datums and which two are not. And so the way the part functions is that all the holes contribute equally to locating the part. That's probably also the way the part's going to be manufactured. These four holes are just going to be drilled at the same time. And when somebody gauges the part, you've got four holes called out MMC, MMB. There's probably going to be a fixed gauge with four pins that goes through four holes. It fits over all four pins at the same time. And if it fits over all four pins at the same time and lays flat on surface A, then these callouts are going to be considered to have been met. So the way the part functions, the way the part is manufactured, and the way the part is going to be gauged, all say these four holes contribute equally, and these two holes are not more important than these two holes. So how should we dimension this part? Like this. We should use a pattern datum. Four times, tolerance of position, max material condition, and that's it. And that is datum B. Four holes constitute a pattern that is datum B. And when we want to locate this hole relative to the four holes, we locate it with a tolerance of position at max material condition to A primary, and then B at max material boundary, secondary, and that's it. We're done. Because A primary takes out 3 degrees of freedom. The pattern of four holes takes out the other 3 degrees of freedom, and that fully constrains the part. And this hole is located to these holes, and the way it's tolerance now is the way it functions, it's the way it's going to be manufactured, it's the way it's going to be gauged. This is the appropriate way to do it. This reflects reality. This does not reflect reality. This reflects reality. So I hope now, when I look at least drawings that you make, when I see four holes that constitute a pattern, four holes that contribute equally to the location of this part, I will see them called out with pattern datums rather than seeing them called out with two datums called out as B and C and then everything else located to B. Use the pattern datums when it's appropriate. That's my rant for today. Please visit my website at dimensionalconsulting.com. Thank you.